have with us today: Yash Patil, Group CEO; Vikram Rajput, Head Investor Relations and Corporate Finance; and Pawan Lohia, Head of Finance. Before we begin, I would like to state that some of the statements in today's discussion may be forward-looking in nature and may involve certain risks and uncertainties. A detailed statement in this regard is available on the Q1 FY22 results presentation that has been sent to you earlier. I would now invite Mr. Yash Patil to begin the proceedings of this call.
Good afternoon, everyone. A very warm welcome to everyone present, and thank you for joining us today to discuss the operating and financial performance of Kulthi Patil Developers Limited for the first quarter ended 30 June 2021. I look forward to interacting with all of you as we move forward on the path at Kulthi Patil. I would like to begin by discussing how we are seeing the real estate environment shaping up, the strategy of the company, and broad highlights of the quarter. Vikram will take you through the key financial highlights, and we then look forward to taking your questions and suggestions. As the country and all of mankind continues to face the unprecedented challenge of the COVID-19 pandemic, I hope all of you, along with your family and friends, are doing well and keeping healthy. Our thoughts are with those who have been affected. At Kulthi Patil, we have prioritized the health and well-being of our employees, along with their families as well as our customers. We have run vaccination drives across our three operating regions of Pune, Mumbai, and Bangalore. We have also ensured that all our office locations and construction sites operate within the safety protocol and look forward to the world returning to normalcy in the near future. As many of you are aware, and there are several reports stating it, the entire real estate ecosystem has changed over the last few years, where all stakeholders, including developers, channel partners, bankers, suppliers, customers, et cetera, are focused on execution, quality, transparency, and governance. The industry is getting consolidated and formalized. First, it was due to RERA, then GST, then demonetization, then NBFC crisis, and now due to the pandemic. This is set to benefit branded developers with strong balance sheets who have a history of timely delivery and execution like Kulthi Patil. This was evident in our strong performance in the second half of last year and the healthy performance we have reported this quarter. We have delivered an encouraging performance in the backdrop of challenging business conditions. As you know, the improving operating environment created during the second half of the last financial year was marred during the months of April and May with the sharp escalation of COVID cases as the second wave spread across the country. As the virus spread, stringent lockdowns impacted business operations. The impact on human and commercial activity was felt even more in urban centers, including our core markets of Pune, Mumbai, and Bengaluru. Understandably, there was muted real estate activity in the first 2 months of quarter one. During this period, our focus has remained on business sustenance. We reported a sales value of 249 crore during quarter one, which was 51% year-on-year improvement. Our reported sales volume of 0.4 million sq ft was higher by 26% year-on-year. Our successful diversification initiatives continue to materialize as sales value contribution of Mumbai and Bengaluru stood at 36%, further driving a 20% YOY appreciation in average realizations. The average realizations have been steadily improving and are at 6,261 in Q1 FY22. We look to take this momentum forward and will look to consolidate presence in Pune while expanding into Mumbai and Bengaluru markets from the current base. We see progressively encouraging demand dynamics in each of the three geographies based on the improvement seen in the month of July and the visibility during the current quarter till date. During the first quarter, we launched two new redevelopment projects in Mumbai's western suburbs, Verve in Goregaon West and Vayu in Dahisar West. The lockdown allowed us for only soft launches of these projects, and yet traction in these locations was encouraging with aggregate sales value of rupees 30 crore. Both are prominent locations in popular suburban areas, and we see continued strong sales visibility at fairly robust APRs. Our confidence is also based on our recent success and strong sales momentum seen since the launch of Evara at Borivali West about 6 months back. Evara is our first launch in Mumbai in the last 4 years, and in this project, we have already sold 96% of the total inventory. Now, as the curves are eased progressively and sales and marketing activity increases, we expect a similar pickup in sales at Verve and Vio in the coming quarters. During Q1, our Mumbai portfolio reported a sales value of over Rs. 64 crore compared to less than 3 crore in the same quarter last year. In addition to that, Bengaluru sales during Q1 were more than Rs. 24 crore. Although projects outside Pune represented more than 35% of our overall sales in Q1, which is the highest level of non-Pune contribution in any one quarter till date. This also aligns well with our focus on business de-risking that I talked about earlier. Even within the Pune market, sales contribution is getting to be more broad-based contributions, increasing from non-Life Republic projects. We see further diversification within the portfolio as planned launches begin to contribute. With these projects on the ground, we expect the market share in Pune to continue to rise in future. We look forward to greater intensity in business development activity. We are cognizant of the strong cash flow and returns generating business that we have built and remain focused on strong sustainable growth. In July, we also announced the creation of a residential development platform with our partner Planet Smart City, which is a global leader in smart affordable housing. The objective is to develop 15,000 units on this platform, with the focus primarily being on smart aspirational housing projects in Pune, Mumbai and Bengaluru. The platform will enable us to capture structured outright land purchase transactions on an opportunistic basis while maintaining a healthy balance sheet at Koltepattan. We expect to generate substantial earnings in the coming years with significant contribution to our growth. This development follows the success of Universe at Sector Art and Life Republic, which was the first co-development between KPDL and Planet Smart City. With this platform, we are also introducing something new to the Indian home buyer. With a focus on sustainability and technology, we are looking at introducing smart, holistic and socially inclusive community-centric living in India. As we move into the second quarter, the outlook of the business continues to be positive. We see an increasing recognition among landowners and small developers of the win-win proposition of engaging with large branded developers like Koltepattan, who can drive stronger sales velocity on the back of a strong brand, customer confidence and execution capabilities backed by lower cost of capital and superior cash flow generation capabilities. At Koltepattan, our focus will be on capital-light, deferred payment, structured transactions, including outright purchases, joint ventures, joint development agreements, and profit share. We believe that these structures, when combined with growing volumes, will translate into profitable growth, positive cash flows, and strong ROCEs. In combination with Planet platform, our low debt and strong cash flows provide us enough headroom to pursue our business development plans. We have recently strengthened our executive team and are gearing up the organization for the scale-up in operations. From a strategy, growth, and diversification perspective, there are no changes in our plans. Our sales ambition of 5 million square feet remains very much in focus. However, our vision is not just to focus on sales area, but grow on all parameters like sales value, collection, EBITDA, PAT, ROE, and ROCE. We envision that KPDL will graduate into a leading real estate developer, not only in sales and financial parameters, but also from a customer, employee, and sustainability perspective in the coming years. With that, now I hand over the proceedings of this call to Vikram to provide a financial overview.
Thank you, Yash. Good afternoon, everyone. I hope that all of you and your families are keeping safe and well.
I will now briefly take you through our financial performance for the quarter ended June 30th, 2021. Based on CCM reporting in Q1, we reported revenues of Rs. 197 crore, up 40% on a year-over-year basis. EBITDA for the quarter stood at 62.5 crore compared to a loss of Rs. 12.5 crore in Q1 FY21. Our net profit after tax post minority interest expanded to Rs. 29.5 crore compared to a loss of 27 crore in Q1 FY21. The workforce impact in second wave was lesser compared to Q1 FY21, and an optimal workforce ensured construction activities continue at a healthy pace. This, in combination with new sales, translated to Q1 FY22 collections of Rs. 279 crore, which is up 167% on a year-over-year basis. The liquidity in our business operations remains strong, resulting in further reduction of net debt by 29 crore. Our net debt to equity stands at 0.3x as on June 30, 2021. Further, operating cash flow for the quarter stood at Rs. 78 crore. We expect to report an improved performance across operational and financial parameters for the remainder of the year and end the year on a strong note. On that note, I conclude my opening remarks and would like to now ask the moderator to open the line for Q&A. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may please press star, then one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star, then two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. To ask a question, please press star, then one. The first question is from the line of Bajrang Bafna from Sunidhi Securities. Please go ahead.
Congratulations for a very strong set of numbers and welcome ESG as a CEO of the company. So really congratulations, sir, for your new journey in the company. My first question is pertaining to, the new technology that you just have talked about, bringing high-tech homes at affordable category in India. And in that journey, you have partnered with Planet of UK. So if you could guide us, this sort of what exactly that, the differentiation that you are talking about and what kind of, value proposition that we have to offer to consumers in the times to come. Because when we'll talk about real estate, frankly, we have never heard, these high-tech homes and these sort of terminologies as of now, especially in Mumbai, it's really unheard of. So if you could guide us on that platform, what sort of proposition that this Planet is going to give us will be really helpful.
Hi, Bajra. Thank you for your question. So I think on talking of our platform that we have created with Planet Smart City, so Planet is a global smart affordable housing developer, and giving the expertise in the PropTech space, we thought to bring in smart solutions. They have over 150 smart solutions from which we can choose and bring that to the Indian consumer. So we thought of basically bringing a differentiating product to the Indian market, and the success of which has been seen in our sector R10 at Life Republic, which we called Universe, where instead of just providing, say, a clubhouse, we are trying to give an innovation center where there's a space for co-living, there is a Planet app where you can monitor, the air quality, and there'll be a community manager. So this is the kind of differentiation we want to bring in, and we want to bring in the global know-how through this partnership. As KPTL has already, we have the Indian expertise, and we hope to, bring a product to the Indian consumer which they have not experienced before.
Okay. And in terms of, apart from Planet, can we see these sort of high-end partnerships, even going forward? In these high-tech homes, because Pune and Bengaluru, both the cities are anyway known for IT professionals, and most of the demand that gets created in these cities is predominantly from, these professionals. So can we expect these sort of technical tie-ups, or the technological tie-ups even going forward?
Yes, absolutely. So it would, as you rightly mentioned, that, Pune and Bengaluru, where we are present, the TG is mainly the IT TG. And apart from this platform, we are evaluating other partnerships also, where depending on the project, we would, you know, do a sort of a technology tie-up with them and, you know, try to bring in differentiation in terms of bringing in smart living solutions to our projects.
Okay, got it, sir. And, you know, ESG, can you just guide us in terms of what exactly, you know, is changing in this real estate despite being, you know, lockdowns and this COVID thing? You know, actually we are hearing from most of the real estate players that, you know, they are seeing a good amount of traction and very hopeful of, you know, this even going forward. So maybe, you know, we normally hear that the shift from unorganized to organized is happening. But if you could briefly, you know, tell us what is the experience that you have been seeing in this COVID environment, why the sales are, you know, moving up and why we are so hopeful that, you know, the future is more optimistic, you know, than what the dull 10 years that we have seen in this sector. So what really is changing, you know, in this space will be really helpful.
No, so what we are seeing on ground is the consolidation story playing out. We are seeing that, you know, the buyers and all the different stakeholders, bankers, they all are preferring to tie up with branded developers who have good execution capabilities and, you know, are able to deliver good products on time. So, you know, we being one of the branded developers who have been able to maintain a healthy balance sheet, as it's evident that, you know, despite the pandemic in this quarter, we are able to reduce our debt by around 39 crore. And I think our debt position is now around 280 crore. Yeah. So we are seeing that, you know, the customers, you know, the landowners, they all are preferring to tie up with branded developers as there are, you know, some people are facing liquidity issues in the sector.
Okay. One thing I just would like to clarify, since you are based out of, you know, Pune, which is the city or hub of IT professionals, you know, our channel checks are indicating that, you know, the IT professional salaries over last 3-4 years, you know, especially the software engineers or the application developers have gone up tremendously, you know, maybe from, let's say, 30 lakhs to almost 80 lakhs to 1 crore with having 3-4 years kind of experience. So are these, you know, IT sales are culminating into real estate demand, especially in Pune, to that sense, like in terms of affordability, might be 3 years back, they were looking at 30-40 lakhs worth of house. Now they are looking at might be 80 lakhs to 1 crore kind of worth of house. So all these indications, you know, probably which you are getting from channel checks, are you people are also seeing the same happening on the ground with us?
Yes, so actually Life Republic, which is one of our flagship townships, which is based in Hinjewadi, which is an IT hub, the, you know, the kind of walk-ins we are seeing and the kind of inquiries that we are getting, I think now people are preferring, you know, bigger homes. You know, we have, you know, 600, 800 square feet, 1, 2 BHK. But now R1 sector, where we have a 1,000 square feet, sort of a 2 BHK, we are seeing more traction there. So I think we are seeing that the IT, you know, people have more disposable income and people are preferring to buy bigger homes, which is evident from, you know, our project of Life Republic.
Okay. And my last question pertains to your overall, you know, guidance that, you know, since now you are at the leadership position in the company, you know, and going to drive the future of, you know, Kolte with your professionals. So what sort of, you know, guidance that probably you would like to give us? Because if I remember correctly, you know, when the Gopal was at the helm, he was guiding almost the delivery of more than 5 million square feet by 2024. So are we still sticking with that guidance, or, you know, how you want to guide us, you know, in terms of the forthcoming trajectory for the company over next 3-4 years kind of time frame? Thank you, sir.
Yeah. No, absolutely. I think, you know, with the way the industry is growing and with the way the consolidation is playing out, although, you know, not don't want to give any sort of a forward guidance, we are our sales ambition of 5 million square feet remains very much in focus. However, like I had mentioned before, that, you know, our vision is not just to focus on sales area, but it's also to grow on all parameters like the sales value, collection, EBITDA, PAT, deliveries. So we want to be, you know, one of the leading real estate players, not only in terms of sales and financial parameters, but also from a, you know, customer, employee and sustainability perspective in the coming years.
Thank you very much, sir. I'll come in the queue for follow-up questions. Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Parikshit Kandpal from HDFC Securities. Please go ahead.
Hi, Yash. Congratulations on assuming the leadership role. My first question is on the overall business development pipeline in your respective markets. So if I look at Mumbai, you have now quite a decent presence from 6-7 projects, some projects already launched and some in the pipeline. So do you think that now you have gained enough mass in the Mumbai market where the tenants or the redevelopment societies who are looking for redevelopment recognize you as a formidable player in this market and they start engaging more with you, and which in turn will help you ramp up significantly on the redevelopment pipeline in Mumbai? So that's my first question.
Yeah, so hi Parikshit. I think on the redevelopment front, of course, you know, we have been present in the Mumbai market for now over 7 years. And, you know, after delivering 2 projects successfully now in that market and having 3 projects, which we have just launched this year, we are looking to build that platform as our redevelopment team is in place. And, you know, redevelopment being such a model which is based on trust, I think societies are also trusting us. And, you know, in the coming quarters, we'll hope to add more projects in the redevelopment portfolio. And as for you, what was your second question?
Yeah, it's the same thing. So I was saying, have the society started engaging more with you since they see you as a formidable player now? So are you seeing increased traction in more societies are you looking to tie up? And also, if you can highlight what kind of single size projects you're looking to take in terms of GDP values, so gross development potential. So how much will these societies each have? So if you have some target in mind that you want to be 300, 400 or 500, not below a certain number, so you can guide us on that also.
So yes, of course. I mean, there are a lot of inquiries coming towards our way, and now the minimum that we have set with the team is a 50 crore pack. Projects that have a 50 crore pack, we are evaluating those projects going forward.
So, and how many of these you are looking to add in this financial year? So if you have to build a business development pipeline in Mumbai, in terms of GDP addition, are you looking to add 3, 4, 5, 6? So how many of these projects in a sense are you looking to add every year?
So for this year, we have, you know, Golden Pebbles, Sukh Nivas, Jeevan Sudha, you know, with a, I think, 0.13 million square feet is Golden Pebbles, Sukh Nivas is 30,000, and Jeevan Sudha is 1,20,000. And the other proposals are under discussion, and as and when we sign our, you know, DAs, we will make those announcements.
So I was asking your guidance on how many new, besides the ones we already have, so how much of incremental GDP additions you are looking to do in Mumbai on an annual basis. If you can get some sense on that, like cumulatively these projects together can add potentially say 1,000 crore on your GDP or 1,500 crore on GDP. So how will we see this GDP built up happening now in the Mumbai market?
So we already have, you know, 2-3 projects lined, 2 projects which are live, 2 projects which are going to be launched, 3 projects which are going to be launched in the next year. And every year we are looking to, you know, have at least 2 live projects in Mumbai in the next 3 to 4 years.
So every year you will add about 2 projects, which you can see add about 100
projects. This is not limited to redevelopment. This could also be JD, JV, profit sharing structures.
Okay.
Since we have built a good visibility and good brand presence here, so we are getting inquiries for the non-redevelopment deals as well. And in the coming quarters, we are hoping to, you know, announce some positive news on that.
Okay. So, yes, if I see your numbers for a long time have been hovering in that range of 1,200 or 1,300 kind of pre-sales. We have been replenishing on whatever is the drop with new market. So, when do we see the growth momentum now coming in? As you said, that things are looking up now. So, from here on, do you think over the next 2-3 years, there could be a sustainable growth coming in from the newer markets, which could incrementally add to the previous momentum?
Yeah. Yes. So, I think I was just losing your voice there. I think for this year, we are targeting to have our best ever growth in terms of sales value. And you are right, we have been hovering around the 1,200 crore mark since the past couple of years, which now as a team, we have taken a target to beat.
Okay. Just lastly, on the launch thing, so you have about 7 million square feet of launches planned in this financial year. So, do you think all these launches will see the, how much of this can be launched in this year, or do you think the entire 7 million will be launched, or there will be phases like phase 1 of these which will get launched this year and maybe next year there will be a spillover? So how do we reach the 7 million number?
So out of the 7.2 million of our launches, Baner, which is 1.3 million, would come in Q3. Kharadi would also come in Q3, which is around 0.68 million square feet. Wagholi Aqua also awaiting EC, so that also we are positive would come in Q3. And Life Republic and Art and Sector would again come in Q3. And the remaining would come in Q4. So, the projects that, apart from this, there are few projects that would also come, in next year as they are awaiting certain approvals.
Okay, that's all from my side, Yash, and thank you and all the best and wish you all the success.
Thank you
for the leadership position.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Manoj Dua from Geometric. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Yash, and thank you, Vikram. So congratulations, Yash, on joining Kolte Patil as CEO. So Gopal has also done wonderful work in making the architect of the company. It's great to have a owner mindset to take the decision, which is good for the business in long term, and be aggressive when it is needed most. So I think it's very fortunate that Kolte, the owner, has joined the management. So my two, three questions are there, and earlier participants have also touched on these important facts like redevelopment scalability, and we are stuck between 2 to 3 million square feet for a decade. So, and your balance sheet is also very good at this time. So what aggression, what pipeline we can add in 1 or 2 years, as we have like vision of 5 million square feet. For that, we need to be ongoing and project under approval around 24 times that. So this is area which I'm trying to understand more, when we can move forward and how much deals we can add in 1 or 2 years for that. Thank you.
Thank you, Manoj. I think, of course, I mean, this quarter, our platform deal with Planet is evident that we are here to grow and be aggressive on our growth parameters. And to achieve, of course, I don't want to give any forward guidance, but to achieve the 5 million square feet mark, there are many deals now that are under evaluation and under our due diligence stage. So I'm hoping that in the coming quarters, we will announce good deals as the team has been strengthened, our business development team, and you would see some good announcements in the coming quarters.
Okay. My second question is regarding that you have touched upon that we have made some changes in organizational structure. So can you throw some more color on that if possible?
I think we have gotten a top team in place now with a CFO and our COO, and also today I think our CMO also joins us. So our top team is in place, our mid-level team is already there, and now with the new energy and the new focus, we are hoping to be one of the leading real estate players in India.
Okay. Third and last was regarding redevelopment. As you know, that Mumbai has very less land particles and where we can buy, because already very crowded. And redevelopment can give us a very long runway. And you have shown us it is very high ROC business also and very less capital intensive. But we have to win the trust of the society. And now with COVID, I believe that everybody wants to live better balconies and something like that. So our society is coming to you. Is lead coming more? Are you adding more team to part to the Mumbai redevelopment team? So I would like to get more color on the redevelopment, how big we can do. Many big players are coming like Oberoi and Lodha. I think it will lead to more formalization of this society redevelopment. Are you thinking big in society redevelopment is my question.
Yes, I mean, absolutely. I think, having, like I said before, like having built our expertise in redevelopment and shown good deliveries, I think we have built a good presence in the redevelopment space. And like I highlighted before, that there are more societies coming towards us with their proposals as now the confidence, as, there's more confidence built within the market. And
excuse me, this is the operator. Participants, the line for the management has dropped. We request you to stay connected while we reconnect the management. and gentlemen, thank you for patiently waiting. The line is reconnected. Sir, you may go ahead. Mr. Dua is on the line with us.
I have asked a question.
Apologies, everyone. I think the line got disconnected. We are reconnected. Yash will take over on the redevelopment question.
Yeah, Manoj. So to continue, I think, from your question of redevelopment, I think I was just saying, touching up that we have three live projects going on, and you know we are going to add another three projects in the coming quarters. So we'll always have 2 to 3 live projects, in the redevelopment space, and we are re-spending our team even more as we are looking out for more, mentioned by Vikram, more projects apart from redevelopment. We are looking also in for JV and JDA transactions.
Okay, thank you and best of luck.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Pritesh Sheth from Motilal Oswal. Please go ahead.
Hi, thanks for the opportunity. Firstly, Yash, congratulations on your appointment as the group CEO and all the best for your tenure. My question is on the partnership that you have signed with Planet, just dwelling upon further details. So firstly, how will the structure work out in terms of the project development? We'll be targeting these partnerships in both existing land parcels as well as the new land parcels, or we'll be purely looking out for new parcels? And in case, if you are going to be looking out for new land parcels, how will you prioritize that for the partnership or the non-partnership land parcels? That is my first question.
So, hi, Pritesh. I think the partnership with Planet Smart City is going to be new developments, new deals outside our portfolio, as we are targeting Pune, Mumbai, and Bangalore. And I think they would be mostly transactions that would be outright transactions in a structured manner.
Okay. And what would be the role of Planet? Purely just providing the technology in terms of development, or whether they'll be deploying initial money for the land acquisitions as well?
So yeah, it would be multifold. They would be deploying the money for the land acquisition and also deploying the technology, because as we speak, I think they already have a team of 3 to 4 Italians who are currently sitting in Pune, who are monitoring our projects at art and sector. So as new deals keep getting added on this platform, I think they would expand their team also, where there would be good knowledge share, from our team here and their Italian team, which has a global knowledge on smart affordable housing.
Right. And you mentioned that now the customers are also preferring larger houses versus that. I mean, in Life Republic, our ticket size in this Planet partnership was largely around 30 to 50 lakhs. Are they adaptable to this flexibility in terms of making a larger size or they are largely focused on the affordable part as well? Below 50 lakh ticket size?
No, I think it's a affordable come aspirational housing platform, and they are open because we have launched only once 3 buildings in R10. So they are open for suggestions and to explore bigger homes. So we have so far launched 600-800 square feet homes. So they are open to the idea of launching 800 to 1000 square feet homes also, as that's where the demand is.
Right. And lastly on this, sorry. So earlier for our Life Republic, our partnership was around 10% our stake and 90% their stake with a ROE hurdle rate. Going forward, how would the partnership terms be? Will it be 50-50 or it's on a case to case basis?
Pritesh, Vikram here. Hi. So it will be on a deal to deal basis. The percentage will differ depending on the size of the deal. Also, we're looking to add around 8 to 10 projects in this deal. So it will depend, which project, what suits, what percentage suits us.
Okay.
But you are right, there will be a hurdle rate, and post that hurdle rate, it will be 50-50% of profit share.
Got it. Okay, that's it from my side. And all the best to you, Yash, and the whole team.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Prithvi Raj from Unify Capital. Please go ahead.
Just coming to the Planet Smart City, you know, you're talking about 8 projects. Quantify, you know, roughly in the square feet number, how much can be the potential from this project?
Can you repeat the question?
Can you quantify the volume number for the Planet City? You know, how much can be the potential over the next few years from this platform?
Like I said, you know, 8 to 10 projects. So it can be anywhere between 8 to 12 million.
And then if I understand right, so entire land costs will be by the Planet City and company, Colcha will do only the execution part. Is that right?
No. So whatever percentage of the deal for a project, suppose it is 20, 80 or 30, 70. So in that ratio, Planet will pay and we will pay.
Okay.
Or invest.
Okay. And, you know, coming to the Bangalore, you know, what exactly company is doing, you know, in Bangalore? Because Mumbai, you were mentioning about redevelopment, etc. I mean, what exactly are we doing to increase our sales in Bangalore market?
So, I think in Bangalore now we have square feet of unsold inventory. And now we are looking to add deals in the JV-JD structure. So, we have Raga 3 already, which is planned, which is on Hennu Road, which is a phase 3 of our Raga project of about 0.25 million square feet, which we hope to launch in the coming quarters. Coming quarter 3 or quarter 4, depending on approvals.
Okay. So given your focus on Bangalore and Mumbai, so how much can be the non-Pune market say in a couple of years' time? Is there any number that companies are targeting?
So it will vary year on year, but it can be anywhere from 25 to 35. So this year the number is on the higher side. If we are selling more from Pune, maybe next year, then it can change. But 25 to 35 is what we see.
And one final question. So given the launch pipeline for the second half, what kind of sales, you know, are we targeting for this year and the next year?
So I think from sales value, like I said before, we are targeting our best ever sales value that has been done in the, you know, in our company's history. And I think that's all from the sales value. Sorry?
On the square feet side.
So it will be north of 2.5 million square feet. It could be way higher also, but it depends on, you know, what launches come in Q3 and Q4. So our focus is very much on growing and, you know, doing our best on not only on sales value, also even collections or, you know, the revenue and PAT. This will be a very good number. But we don't want
to expect this number. And can we expect this? I mean, can we expect something like 4 million for next year? Is it that company focusing on?
So we hope to, like, you know, Yas said, we hope to again grow every year at least minimum of 20%. So I would not like to commit to 4 million or 3.5 or 3 or anything. But you can see quarter or quarter our performance will, you know, improve. And then we are in a better position to comment on next year in maybe Q3 or Q4. But obviously to reach 5 million square feet, you have to start at 3 and then it goes to 3.5, 4, 4.55. So incrementally every year the focus is, you know, on all parameters, area and value. There will be good growth.
Okay, thank you. That's all from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Alpesh Thakkar from Antique Stock Broking. Please go ahead.
Thank you for taking up my questions and congratulations for a good set of numbers despite the challenges. My first question pertains to the pricing environment. So how do you look at the pricing environment turning out given the fact that, you know, the momentum for the sales have been strong after both the, you know, unlockdowns that has happened. So how does the pricing look?
Yeah, I think on the pricing front, given that there is strong momentum now and, you know, with the easing of the lockdown and also with the, you know, cost pressure because of input costs going up, we may consider increasing prices in the coming quarters depending on the project, because some projects we could increase prices, but in some projects, depending on the competition, we may, you know, choose to maintain, to have a stable pricing and not increase the price there. But you would see some increase in prices in the upcoming quarters in some of our projects.
Okay. So what kind of, you know, just to quantify how much percentage of the cost would have increased and how much kind of price increase are we looking to take in case we do that?
So price increase would be 2-5% and cost per one.
So on a cost basis, more or less around 5% has been the cost escalation because of steel and cement prices going up. So we propose to pass on 50% of that to the customers.
Okay, fair enough. So, and the second thing is, you know, on your last slide, you know, we have like good aspirations to become, you know, top 5 developers in the country. And given Coal Department's, you know, history of execution and all, it definitely looks so. So just wanted to understand from the strategy point of view, how do we target doing that going forward? And what would be our key focus area? Will it be the focus on the affordable side or some other segments? So just you know, thoughts on that would be very helpful. That's
our
it from my
strategy, yes, our strategy is very clear. It's to expand within the 3 micro markets that we are present in, and this will be done through you know, JV, JD, and profit share, and some structured outright deals. And it would be to basically we would add projects in all segments, be it 24K, our townships, MIG, and affordable. So we would add all projects in these segments, not any specific segment.
Okay, okay. That's it from my side, and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Himanshu Upadhyay from PGIM. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi, good afternoon. And congratulations on being reaching the position of CEO. My first question was, you said that in Bombay, you want to look at redevelopment projects where you can get a 50 crore PAT, okay? Am I right in hearing that? This is
yes.
What you... So, does it also mean that some of the smaller projects, what we used to do earlier, or even we have right now, where the sales potential is only 0.03 million square feet, those we'll like to avoid and do at least... projects where we can have a sales of more than a lakh square feet only now from here on?
Yeah, so very much so, you know, those projects were signed from a visibility perspective. If you see, they are in different regions of Mumbai and also as a entry strategy for us. You know, it was a very capitalized strategy. Going forward, like Yash mentioned, you know, we are looking at slightly bigger deals compared to those. So at least a minimum PAT of 50 crores.
So how does it evolve on the... how much of square footage feet project you want to do? Can you give the reverse calculation?
Areas of Mumbai will have different rates, right? Some project in a standalone building with few floors also can fetch that amount of money. Maybe it's in Khar or Bandra West, and something in Dahisar you will have to sell substantially higher to achieve that.
Okay. And one more thing. So we have completed 2 projects in Bombay, okay? So we have this Jai Vijay, which is still unsold inventory is there, okay? And even when we see the 3 new launches, the unsold, it seems the value is good, but sales area remains small. So can you tell what you are looking on how to distribute and increase your sales velocity? And as higher size number of projects starts coming up, so can you elaborate and what brand you are trying to build in Bombay? So just some thoughts on your brand building and your sales strategy. How do you view to increase the sales momentum in your project?
So on a sales strategy point of view, I think JVJ, now that the you know, it's an OC ready project, you will see good traction. We are running a freedom campaign already in the project, and in terms of Verve and Vayu, I think Ivara was launched in January and 96% of the project is sold out. So there was good traction there. And in terms of Ivara, Vayu and Verve, the sales office is being built and there is construction going on. So I think, you know, with Q3 and the festivities picking up and positive sentiments in the consumers, a good inventory would be sold.
Any special efforts you are making or how would be your sales channel or process in Bombay? Will it be any different than Pune? Any special efforts you think you need to take to, let's say, reach 500,000 square feet type of sales in few years in Bombay. So can you elaborate on that?
No, I think it's like I said, there are very few branded developers who are present in the redevelopment space, and that is very evident from launching Evara, where we sold out the project in 3 to 4 months of launch. And the same we are seeing now with our other projects, that the customers are preferring the branded developers. So we are, apart from our sales office, our sales experience, our AVs, visuals and all that, I think customers are preferring branded developers. And in Bombay, the location also sells. So these are very good strategic locations, being Goregaon and, the Dahisar West. So they are good locations that are commanding a good demand.
And one more thing. Can you add one point in your presentation? This has been a request for a very long period of time. What is the value of ongoing and unsold inventory and capex requirement to complete this ongoing and unsold inventory? Okay, some rough estimates to understand cash flows, the potential cash flows in the future. And one more thing, you have done this strategic sale of land, okay? Have we got the cash in our balance sheet, the strategic monetization what we did? So have we got the cash?
So
out of 172 crores of the total deal value, only 33 crores is pending to be received. Rest all we have received.
So we have recognized 81 crores of from land monetization. Okay.
This was phase two. Phase one was already recognized last year.
Yeah, so out of 81, if we look the cash, what's that?
So out of 81, only 33 is pending and the balance is received.
So in this quarter, did we receive any cash?
Yeah, we have received.
Okay, so 33 crore land monetization.
That's right.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, and one last question on the platform what you have done. That platform aim will also be to be capital light, or you are ready to acquire land through that platform? Okay, so in Bombay what model we have is redevelopment, but through that platform do we think that we would like to acquire land and grow the things, because now we have a brand and visibility is there, and even in Bangalore. So can you throw some light on that?
Yeah, absolutely. I think through the platform the focus is to acquire outright transactions in a structured manner. Because, even at Kulte Patil now, with a healthy balance sheet, we can deploy good growth capital. So now we are searching for business development deals for our, aspirational housing, platform. And it won't necessarily be asset-like. The focus is on structured outright transactions.
So even in Bombay?
Yes. Even in Bombay, in terms of, Thane and all the outskirts of Thane, Dombivli, Mulund. So there are some strategic locations that we have highlighted, even in the MMR region. But it would start from, Pune, Bangalore. And then if there's a good deal in Bombay, that also we'll put in the platform.
Okay. And can you elaborate on the micro markets where we are present? What is the value? The land, has some price correction happened, or you think the prices are remaining there? So nothing interesting is there? Okay. Just the way the markets are, the micro markets where you are present.
No, so I think the micro markets we are present, there is no price correction as such that we are seeing in terms of land value. But of course, like I said, there are deals are coming at better terms in terms of, structuring them or linking them to certain, CPs.
Okay. Thank you from my side.
Thank you.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Aegis Lakhani from Unify Capital. Please go ahead.
Yeah, sir, a quick question on Bangalore and Mumbai geographies. I'd like to understand that when you decide to select a particular project in a specific micro market, the nuances of different micro markets are different. So how do you approach it? So, for example, in Bombay, since you have done projects in Goregaon and Dahisar and Borivali, will you then look for more projects around this cluster, or are you of the approach that, okay, wherever there is a higher profitability per project, which you have indicated from a 50 crore perspective, is where you will levitate then?
Yes, so I think it's project that fit into our financial feasibility, where we have good ROCs, say between 14% to 18%. We are evaluating those kind of projects. So the micro markets could be different, but if it's a good deal and if it's fitting within our financial parameter and our technical and legal due diligence is also a go ahead from those legal and technical teams, we are evaluating these projects more seriously.
Got it. So the decision to enter a micro market is not based on your ability to understand the demand supply there, but it's driven more by the ROC that you may have on the project. And this is for Bangalore and Bombay, right?
Yes, yes, absolutely. Because we believe Pune, Bangalore itself is a good market by itself. So, then it just depends on the financial, like I mentioned, the financial feasibilities. And wherever they are matching with our conditions of financial feasibility and a technical and legal due diligence, we are aggressively pursuing those deals to bring them to a closure stage.
Got it. Thanks. I'm done.
Thanks.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that was the last question. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Yash for closing comments.
Thank you once again for your interest and support. We will continue to stay engaged. Please be in touch with our investor relations team for any further details or discussions. Look forward to interacting with you next quarter.
Thank you very much, sir. Ladies and gentlemen,